ED Sports. This is the third game of the 2021 Holiday Classic. Our third game is going to be the first of the boys' matchups. This one will be between the Shoreland Lutheran Pacers and the Reuther Bulldogs. We're going to head down to the court where they are going to present our starting lineups for today's game.
Senior number 24, Ryan Scott. Senior number 32, Elvis Seipel. Senior number 44, Aiden Irby.
The four boys matchups we have here today. We've got Reuther in the white jerseys. He'll be shooting on our right to begin, where Shoreland Lutheran will be working towards the left in the black jerseys with gold trim. Opening tip. Initially won by Shoreland Lutheran. We are underway. Works the ball around the perimeter. Fakes the shot, drives the lane. Pull up is good. Antonio Moya. So Reuther with their first possession on offense. Tries to pass in the post, but that one is deflected. Lutheran going the other way. Tries the outlet pass. That one's deflected by Reuther, like a cornerback trying to swat the pass from behind him. Inbound underneath the basket. Open look for three. That one rattles out. Impressive keep there. He's fouled. Number 21 from Shoreland. Antonio Moyau, who did the save there that allowed the foul there for Lutheran. Two from the line from Shoreland. Generous bounce there on the first. First one's good. Second one rattles out, but the board is taken down by Ruther. Mid-range shot, hits the back of the rim, comes out. Layup, hits the top of the backboard, comes back down to Ruther. Pretty methodical start for this game between both of these teams. Pass over the defender, kicks it back out. Nice little screen there, fade away to the left. He cannot get it anywhere close, so Lutheran picks that up. And that one's picked off. Ruther's got speed going back the other way. Pulls up short, tries the layup, can't get it to go. Rebound brought down by number 32, Nolan Sipoff. Pull up shot. Hits the back of the rim, take brought down by Ruther. Going back the other way. Jumping effort there by the Shoreland defender to try and make a stop there. Layup. Somebody got some arms on it, but it goes. Ruther with their first bucket of the game. It's number 25, Jaden Revell. Pass out. Step back. Hits the front of the rim, bounces around, and good. So that one was a three from Shoreland. Pinned in the corner, works it out. Drives the lane, right hand finish. No, no luck. Deflected to Shoreland. And we'll head the other way. Shoreland pass out, top of the key. No luck. And a foul on Shoreland. Notice the trend early in these games, the audience here at Tar Heel Arena seems to stay quieter for the first half and pick up in intensity as the game goes on. Definitely a larger contingency along the side opposite the benches. A decent crowd here for this game between the Ruther Bulldogs and the Shoreland Pacers. It around. Fakes a few passes. Shoreland draws the charge. It's number 34, Braden Vandewater. Successful draw there. It gives his team possession. Off the three. Good pass inside. Kicks it out. Little mid-range shot. Hits the back. But the rebound is a tie-up.
Jump ball. Ruther ball.
That jump ball will go to Ruther. Somewhat low scoring here to start this game. Steady pace from both teams. Open looks, but not a tremendous amount of luck having things fall on either side so far. Tough carry. Almost gets the layup to go, but no luck. Results in another tie-up, and that is going to be Shortland ball. So a couple tie-ups going each way. Shortland will gain possession. You hate to see that. Bit of a clunky pass there. Ends up clipping the Shortland player in the face. Ruther almost takes advantage. It rims out. It's going back the other way. That one's rebounded by Ruther. Dribbles through traffic. Kicks it back out. Number one wide open. And he hits it. Jermarion Jones hits the three. Feigns the shot, pulls it back. A reset there by Shortland. With the shot, misses. It's 21. Cannot make that one fall. So that one's stripped away. Open look, easy layup. Good outlet there, and Vanderwater buries it. That one misses. Tried the pull-up shot, could not get it to go. Open look from three, hits it. Soren Smith there on the three. Lutheran with a back-to-back three. They have taken the lead by six. Ruther's got to look at doing something different to get their offense going. That layup will not fall. A couple bounces off the rim, but could not go. They've worked their offense around the periphery, but have yet to manage to really make any headway into the teeth of this Shortland Lutheran defense. Nice pass into the post. A couple bounces, and that one falls. Brandon Vanderwater was not a starter in this game, but has been a prolific scorer early in this one. And when hits the back of the rim, Ruther gets their own rebound, and good. Number two, Kamari Lavelle. Three from the corner, air ball, picked up by Ruther. Oh, steal there by Shortland. Can't do anything with it. Almost tripped over the Shortland player. Good pull up though, kicked it back to three. Air ball, effort at the save. No, they're gonna say he stepped out of bounds. So we've got some substitutions here. Thankful for everybody who came out to watch some high school basketball today here at Tarbell Arena at Carthage College. For those of you who couldn't make it, I'm glad you're here on WGDD Sports. Ruther gets their own board back. They're heading the other way. from three. Good effort, but can't hit it. Pulled down. Wide open pass. Leads to a foul. So he misses the first. It's number 22. Bryce Feilstifler. He hits a second. Good pressure there. That one's a foul on Shoreland. Got a little bit too over aggressive there. So Reuther stacks up for the inbound. Bit of an awkward pass out. Handled in the corner. Nice pass low, but he's pinned down there. That's going to be a jump ball. Reuther will maintain possession. Passes it way out. Reuther will get their offense to work. A little bit of an awkward handle there on the dribble. That pass is not intended, but it's deflected, and so it leads to a Shoreland turnover. Goes for the layup, and it's good. A little bit of miscommunication there from Reuther, and it cost him. And a good double team there from Shoreland leads to another turnover in transition, and the lead is going to be double digits. That will lead to our first timeout, the first half. We are going to take a quick break right here. You are watching WGDD Sports. Don't go anywhere.
How much excitement can you fit into a weekend? The Honda Passport is full of possibilities. And with plenty of cargo space and underfloor storage, you can fill it with gear too. Passport has a versatile interior for active lifestyles. Pack your weekend with adventure in the Honda Passport.
It's timeout. We are back. Shoreland off to a commanding lead, 18-7 here. Just over a little half of the first half of this game played. Ooh, and a hard foul there. Reuther player took a lick. Foul is on number 22. Bryce Feilstifler went after the pass. Wasn't intentional, just went up to try and get the pass. Reuther player got there first. He got hit hard. Shoreland not looking to back off here. Good passing in transition. Oh, that one stripped away. Shoreland, nice bounce pass. Easy layup. Shoreland's had a lot of success on the fast break here in the first half. There's a steal off the inbound. Open look from the corner. Hits the rim of the rip. Bad pass. It's difficult to say. Lip of the rim. But that three attempt did. In fact, hit the lip of the rim. So Shoreland Lutheran with a 20-7 lead as they sub in a few new players. Just a little bit too much on that pass. You can tell there's some frustration from the Ruther side. Shoreland works their way down. Pass low down into the post. Looking to give it back, but instead backs his man down. Open look from three. Hits off the rim. Gets their own rebound. Nothing doing on the second attempt. Big man looking to move. Going the other way, but that pass is picked off. Shoreland's got it back. Open lane to the net. That's an easy layup. This one already starting to slip away. 22-7. Shoreland with the lead over Ruther in this one. The pressure from Shoreland is evident. An awkward shot there, but they get it. Tries to make the pass out. Ruther gets the turnover and then makes the bucket. You're Shoreland, you just gotta keep doing what you're doing. Stay patient on offense. Not make careless mistakes. Don't turn the ball over. So this possession goes the other way. Ooh. That is going to be a foul on Ruther. That will go back the other way. Good pass of speed, easy layup. This is number 24, Ryan Strutz. Ruther looking to break double digits here in this half. Tries to drive. And has a blocking foul. So he will shoot two. Number one, Jamarian Jones. Hits his first. Guards a junior standing at 5'9". So we get a couple of quick substitutions. Now it hits the back of the rim, 1-for-2 at the line. That is a travel, so that will be Ruther ball. Not a ton to get excited about for either team so far this half. Shoreland with the lead, but it has been methodical. Whereas Ruther has really struggled to have any success at all. High arcing pass. Works it out for three. Decides to pull up instead. Working around. Mishandles the pass. That one bounces out of bounds. And Shoreland will take possession once again. For Ruther, they've really had trouble with ball security. And a lot of mishandled passes. Shot from three. It's good. Defender in his face. And even still, Angel Ayala manages to hit that one from three. So that one poked out by Sherlin. So Reuther will maintain possession. I want to thank you for tuning in here. 2021 Holiday Classic here at Tarbell Arena at Carthage College. Draws the charge. Number 32, Nolan Sipoff, who drew the charge there. Rather, took the charge. Good effort. Works the ball down low, unable to finish. But he will get two for the charity stripe. Three bounces, clean form. Couldn't get the shot to go. Misses the first. Manages to make the second, so one for two from the line. Impressive effort to get in close there. Draw the foul. Unable to make it, but even to get there and get the shot off was heck of an effort from number one, Jamarian Jones. Really been one of the only players in Reuther who have shown flashes of anything on offense so far in this game. Second shot is good. Shoreland still looking to extend their lead before halftime. Just a little over 2.5 to play here. So that shot is good. Nothing but net from number 22, Bryce Filestifter. Nice double team there. They force the turnover. Oh, good pass. What an effort there on the pass. Filestifter with a bucket, but it was Antonio Moyau who had the beautiful assist, passing it around the Reuther player. Reuther manages to draw a foul going the other way. Generous bounce there in the free throw. So Reuther gets that one to go. Without looking, I have to figure Reuther's gotten probably around half of their 12 points from the free throw line. It's been their main source of offense, but it will not be sustainable if they want any hope of catching up to Shoreland. So works the ball around. It's a bad pass, but we'll go back to Reuther. 2 minutes to play in this half. Just a tick under. Charlotte's still pressing up almost 20. And just knocked the ball out there. So it stays Reuther ball. pass into the post. Plenty of bodies on, though. No luck there. Rebound brought down by number 22, Feilstifter. Give and go passing operation there. Before setting the pick. Drives the lane. No luck there. Kicks it out. Good luck. Unable to get it to land, though. There you go. What a keep there. And the layup. Couldn't get it to go, but... a lot of effort there on the layup. No bounce there on the first. Misses the first of his two free throws. Misses them both, but they manage to get their own rebound back. Loose ball. Reuther manages to get it. Looks like this might end up in the tie. No, they manage to get the pass out. Reuther looking for something to build on before the end of the half. With a floater, and it's good. 32-15 is their score. Open look on the outside. Can't get it to go. But they get their own rebound. Oh, good move behind the back dribble there. Good effort. Can't get it to go, though. Nah, this is going to be a foul. 21 seconds left to go in the half. Not quite running away with it, but it's close. Shoreline more than doubling Reuther's score so far in this first half. Hits the front of the rim. Reuther gets the rebound. Back for three, and he hits it.
Number 23, Hayes from downtown.
Number 23, as Ethan Lynn, DeAndre Hayes. Poor effort there at the end of the half, can't get it to go. And so we will head to halftime. Reuther battles back just a little bit there at the end of the half. We will go into halftime with a score of Shoreland 32, Reuther 18. We're gonna have highlights from the first half. More exciting action here from Tarbell Arena. Don't go anywhere. I'm Jake Keefe with WJDD Sports, and you're listening to the 2021 Holiday Classic.
I see no defeat.
No defeat.
I have the best.
In me.
In me.
So I require the best.
Warriors like us.
We make our own.
We make our own destiny.
We make our own destiny.
We push back in the face of adversity.
We turn up the heat.
Is it in you too?
Make your move.
Make your move.
Make your move.
Make your move.
How much excitement can you fit into a weekend? The Honda Passport is full of possibilities. And with plenty of cargo space and underfloor storage, you can fill it with gear too. The Passport has a versatile interior for active lifestyles. Pack your weekend with adventure in the Honda Passport.
Here's to those who break the mold, to the few who dare to dream. We see you. We understand you. We are you. Bring your ambition to Gateway, and we'll supply the world-class training. Our facilities and programs are state-of-the-art, and our staff are experts in their fields. We're the number one choice for those who want to be a part of something more. Put your ambition into motion at Gateway.
Hello.
What's up?
Hello.
Hello. Hello.
It's just a kind thing to do.
Sometimes he wants friends, so you say hello.
It all starts with hello.
It might change the world and make everybody nicer.
I don't know. Maybe it's just magic.
Maybe if you say hi to one person a day, think about the fact that you might be potentially changing that person's life for the better.
At the University of Wisconsin Parkside, we're producing the next generation of leaders, students studying biosciences, IT, business management, and digital design and fabrication will lead us into a new era of success, powered by bright young minds that solve problems and invent products. And it starts with choosing a university that's affordable, with small class sizes, in-demand programs, and excellent placement rates. See what the future looks like. Visit uwp.edu. Be at Parkside, the University of Wisconsin Parkside.
Support for this broadcast comes from the Kenosha County Aging and Disability Resource Center. Whether you need information about Medicare, housing options, home care, or accessible transportation, the ADRC is the place to start. A trusted resource since 1999, the ADRC is a no-cost, one-stop shop for older people, adults with disabilities, and their families. Call 262-605-6646.
Back halftime here at Tar Bowl Arena. You're listening to, watching, the 2021 Doctors of Physical Therapy and Goat Sports America Holiday Classic, presented by WGTD Sports. I'm Jake, happy to cover the first half, and I'll be here for the second half as well once we get to some highlights. Reuther opened the scoring, but for the most part, this is Charlotte Lutheran's half. They commanded on offense for most of the first half. It was a long stretch of time where Reuther seemed unable to get points on the board. Excellent job in transition by Lutheran, managing to force turnovers, get easy buckets going the other way. Turnover there forced by Reuther, but Shoreland has managed to make some slick passes of their own. Definitely some creativity on the offensive side of the ball by Shoreland. A pull-up jumper there is good. And so if I'm Shoreland Lutheran, I keep doing what I'm doing. You've done really well on offense so far. Don't overthink your game. Just continue to be aggressive. Make these pretty slick plays you've made so far on offense. If you're Reuther, you've kind of got to reevaluate what you're doing on the offensive side of the ball. You've held Lutheran at only about 30 points. It's not too bad so far considering what you're up against, but you need to reevaluate what you're doing on offense. I don't know if that's being more aggressive in the offensive paint, trying to work the ball outside if you've got the shooters where you can make things capable to happen. Basically, what you need to do is continue to do what you're doing on defense and then see if you can maybe shift the momentum on offense. Get on a run. Get hot. Get Shoreland a little bit scared. You never know what may happen. Things could shift in the second part of this game. They had some successful trips down the floor towards the end of that first half. If they can keep that up, this game is not out of the question yet. And we'll see more of that as we come back for the second half. Don't go anywhere. This is WGTD Sports.
I see no defeat.
No defeat.
I have the best.
In me.
In me.
So I require the best.
Warriors like us.
We make our own.
We make our own destiny.
We make our own destiny.
We push back in the face of adversity.
We turn up the heat.
Is it in you too?
Make your move.
Make your move.
Make your move.
Make your move.
How much excitement can you fit into a weekend? The Honda Passport is full of possibilities. And with plenty of cargo space and underfloor storage, you can fill it with gear too. The Passport has a versatile interior for active lifestyles. Pack your weekend with adventure in the Honda Passport.
Here's to those who break the mold, to the few who dare to dream. We see you. We understand you. We are you. Bring your ambition to Gateway, and we'll supply the world-class training. Our facilities and programs are state-of-the-art, and our staff are experts in their fields. We're the number one choice for those who want to be a part of something more. Put your ambition into motion at Gateway.
Hello.
What's up?
Hello.
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 It's just a kind thing to do.
Sometimes he wants friends, so you say hello.
It all starts with hello.
It might change the world and make everybody nicer.
I don't know. Maybe it's just magic.
Maybe if you say hi to one person a day, think about the fact that you might be potentially changing that person's life for the better.
At the University of Wisconsin Parkside, we're producing the next generation of leaders. Students studying biosciences, IT, business management, and digital design and fabrication will lead us into a new era of success, powered by bright young minds that solve problems and invent products. And it starts with choosing a university that's affordable, with small class sizes, in-demand programs, and excellent placement rates. See what the future looks like. Visit uwp.edu. Be at Parkside. The University of Wisconsin-Parkside.
A little bit of cha-cha slide here to bring you back to Tarbell Arena as we get ready for our second half here between Reuther and Shoreland. You're watching the 2021 Holiday Classic. I'm Jay Keefe, filling in for Bob Haggerty here with WGTD Sports. Happy you could make it. Once again, I'd like to wish you a happy holiday weekend, if you had one. And I hope you're settled in for a relaxing Monday with some high school basketball. Couple efforts, couple second chances there from Shoreland. Unable to get the bucket there. So they will retain possession. Works in the paint, kicks it back out. Really good aggressive defense so far here from Reuther to start the second half. That one is off Shoreland. That will be Reuther ball.
Reuther ball.
Nice little up and under there. Reuther with the layup gets a bucket on their first attempt of the half. They get a little bit more aggressive here on defense. Only 12 points here, still anybody's game. Way to come down with the defensive rebound. The Bulldogs will head back up court. Nice little pass. The floater, no luck. A lot of the pressure there on the Shoreland player.
Jump ball.
That is going to be a tie up there. Jump ball.
Ball.
Possession will go back to Shoreland. Possession arrow now lies with Reuther. Correction. The inverse happened. Reuther maintained possession here.
Yeah.
Rough inbound pass. Turned over. Shoreline cuts inside. That shot got blocked, though. Good battle, though, by number 44. Goes up. Aiden Irby gets the bucket. Ugly attempt there. Results in a rebound by Shoreland.
No basket.
That one will not count, unfortunately. Good effort there on the shot. That one was illegal. So Reuther will get the ball back. Soren Smith took a foul on that one. Another foul there drawn by Reuther. This can only help them. Play physically, draw fouls from Shoreland, get to the line and make your shots. Drive on the baseline, can't get it to fall. And it's gonna be a travel. Reuther will once again regain possession. Bad effort there in the inbound by Reuther. Lack of communication leads to the foul. Saw something reminiscent of that. The NBA a few weeks ago, I believe it was James Harden who didn't make an effort to pick up the inbound pass, led to an easy turnover. In this case, leads to free throw shots for Shoreland. Not a lot of happy faces over by the Reuther bench. The fight's got to be there, though. You're only down 14. This is still anybody's basketball game. Big steal there on the inbound by Shoreland. Took a possession away from Reuther, staying aggressive. Easy layup there. Moyo cuts in. Good pressure on defense there. Jamarian Jones got the dribble out of it. That one is going to remain Reuther ball. Shoreland player takes the bump. Nothing doing though. Easy pass up. And a layup. Nothing but space for Vanderwater as he hits the layup. Shoreland has once again almost doubled Reuther's score. Now the lead is 19.
Timeout, Reuther.
That is going to be a timeout from Reuther. I'd like to take the opportunity to remind you that coverage of the 2021 Doctors of Physical Therapy and Go Sports America Holiday Classic, powered by WGTD Sports, is presented by Honda of Kenosha. Tis the season. Build your desired lease for a 2022 Honda online. Visit HondaofKenosha.com. Haibu, it's a premier digital marketing firm. Supercharge your business with the help of Haibu. Learn more at Haibu.com. Gateway Technical College, where your success is their priority. With more than 70 career programs in areas like healthcare, advanced manufacturing, business, IT, and human and protective services. GTC.edu. and the Kenosha County ADRC, a trusted resource since 1999. The ADRC is a no-cost, one-stop shop for older people, adults with disabilities, and their family. Call 262-605-6646. Bon Jovi here, out of the timeout. I don't think that's an accurate assessment of how Ruther is playing on this game. At this point, they're living on a prayer. They would need to generate some more success on the offensive side of the ball if they want any hope of this game. And the way Shoreland is continuing to grind them down, I just don't see it happening. Rough inbound there, but they manage to secure it. That pass is deflected off the Ruther player. It's going Shoreland's way. Shoreland team just appears to be more agile than this Ruther team. They've got quick cuts all game. It's given them opportunities at easy looks and close. Ruther manages to pull that one down, but even when they get back on defense, they're quick enough to get back and cover just like that. Forced pass there. Results in a kickball, but then blocked by Ruther. Tell that Ruther is struggling even to make simple passes at this point. When you can't get the hard ones to go, you start worrying about the simple ones. Oh, nice over the head pass there. Slick assist right there from Ruther. Turnover by Shoreland, so Ruther will take possession. Handful of substitutions for both teams. Almost a triple team there on Jamarian Jones, number one for the Ruther Bulldogs. Good effort there off the fingertips of the Shoreland Lutheran player. The one credit I will give to this Ruther offense, some of the flashier swing passes they've had where they've moved the ball around the defenders for Shoreland have been more successful. Big three there from Ruther. Kamari Lavelle hits it, trims the lead back down to 14. If I'm Ruther, at this point, you're down 14. Maybe don't be afraid to put a little bit more flair on it on the offensive side of the ball. You've had success with that so far. Shoreland's fouled, so they will shoot two from the charity stripe. Number 24, Ryan Schrutz at the line. Sends a wide base, a few bounces, and then drains that first free throw. We'll see if he makes it 2 for 2. Hits them both. Shoreland lead up to 16 now. Just about a third of the play here elapsed in the second half of this game. Good pass. Works it low, just can't get it to fall. Manages to get his own rebound back though. No, he draws the foul. So Ruther will inbound from underneath the basket. No luck on the inbound pass there. Picked off by Shoreland. Oh, wide open look. Short of the lane. Good help defense there by Reuther. Beats the foul. It's number five, Kamari Evans. Junior stands at 6'2". It's his first. Second shot is good. So Reuther down 18, back on offense. Trying to fight through the tie-up. Gets poked loose. Regains the dribble. That is a travel. That will be a turnover. You might have noticed Sherlin has done really well this game, actually. He's upon the initial movement of the player, they've actually swarmed the... They haven't sent doubles initially, but after some movement on offense, what they'll do is they'll swarm the ball carrier. So it's not something that they've necessarily been forced to deal with right away. It's after a couple seconds when they've had possession, they'll realize that they've got a second, a third Shoreland defender draped on them. And because of that, Shoreland's managed to generate these jump balls, these turnovers. I think it's a huge part of why they've got a lead of almost 20 at this point of the game. Quick cuts like that, what are you supposed to do on defense? So they do push it out to 20. Tries to drive in. High bacon shot off the backboard, goes in. Number 24, Paris Roby, the senior, 6'2". Good effort there to defend the shot by Reuther, but that will be Shoreland ball. Just a tick over 10 minutes to play here. Gets the rebound. Heck of a vertical there. And when hits the lip of the rim, it goes out. For three, that's good.
Number 32, Sipoff, for three.
Number 32, Nolan Sipoff, wide open, drains it. Another shot from three. No luck there. Almost worked as a pass. Missed it so bad it went right to his guy in the paint. Number one, Jamarian Jones manages to bury that one. Hard foul there by Reuther. Going to lead to two shots for Shoreland. So number 44, Aiden Irby. Two shots here from the line. First one goes. Like to remind you that for this game, we've got more basketball. 4:30, we're going to have the Burlington Demons playing the Tremper Trojans right here on WGTD Sports. Not even halfway done with today's games. Second shot is good. Shoreland leads by 21. Moving jumper there unsuccessful by Reuther. Nice little pass in the backcourt. Help on defense by Reuther, though, man. She pulled on the rebound. Almost tied up. Ball is stripped. But it was last touch by Shrellin, so the Bulldogs will keep possession. Pretty much an entire substitution for Shoreland. Fresh legs out there for the Pacers. Nice pass down low. Perry, once again, Paris Roby. It's not a misnomer. The Pacers really have kept up the pace of play this game. Some of the cuts they've had on offense has made it really difficult for this Reuther defense to keep pace, keep a lock on this team. That one misses. Rebounded. Number 10, Avante Johnson, comes down with a rebound. And he gets the bucket on the other end. As a turnover by Shoreland. So Reuther regains possession. Make sure you stick around until the end of the game. We've got highlights of the second half, a presentation of the Player of the Game Award, and then, of course, that 4-3 matchup between Burlington and Tremper. So there's a turnover right there by Reuther. Lob down the court. Easy layup. And one. Clockwork for the Pacers. They have an opportunity to convert the three-point play. To the back of the rim. Rebounded by Shoreland. Didn't get the third point, got the ball back. Couple crossovers. Cuts in. No luck though. Rebounded by Reuther. Nice pass over. Jamir Jones. Gentle touch on the layup, but can't get it to go. Still manages to keep his own possession and the bucket. Good fight there by Jamarian Jones. Looks like he could have lost the handle on that one a couple times. He still managed to get the basket. Shot from three. Rebound picked up by Shrellin. And they draw the foul. Pretty steady pace here so far in this one. Shoreland's taken a double-digit lead and hasn't really looked back since early on in this first half, the first half of this game. Breaks it out to the corner. If you're Shoreland, you've been in control all game, no rush, take your time. Make sure you get a decent shot off each possession. There's one, almost rolls in, but he draws the foul. So number 45, as Kamari Evans, he will shoot two. Now the single freshman and only one sophomore on the Shoreland Lutheran team. So he makes his first two free throws. Vanderwaters had quite the impact. He's had quite a few scoring chances in this game. But he is the lone senior on this Pacers team. Sophomore, rather. Good. 35-54. Clock winds under 6 minutes here to play. Got effort on the layup, but can't get it to go. Hits the rim. Bit of a careless pass. Deflects off the Ruther player. Charlotte will maintain possession. Trouble here on the inbound. Shoreline finally works the ball back up court. The pass down low. Nice fight and the bucket. It's all the physicality from Nolan Kruger. 6'3". And a turnover the other way. 5 to play. Shoreline up by 21 in this game. Get the rebound and put it back. Air ball there, picked up by Schroen. Hesitant to use the term garbage time here, so we'll go recycling time, I think is a more generous term. With 4.5 to play, Schroen has been effective all game on offense. I think we'll continue the proofs on that side of the ball until this game ends. So that one almost falls from three. Foul there on Charlotte, so Ruther maintain possession. Looking for a lane to drive in close. Bad pass. Did that deflect off? That will stay. No, they're going to say that kicked off Ruther. So that will be Shoreland ball. Inbound from the corner. Not quite sure what happened there. Seems as though we're back on track, though. Nice little pull-up shot there. Almost got it to go. Shoreland picks up the rebound. Number 41, even in a game that's not really close, put in hard minutes here. Nolan Kruger fights, gets the offensive put back. Ruther player tied up, loses possession. Lutheran finds the guy back door. Hannah Banks in. Soren Smith. From three, can't get it to go. That will be a foul on Ruther. Decent crowd here for this game between the Bulldogs and the Pacers. had some people who appear to be filling in for the later game, and then others who are heading towards the exit. Banks off in front of the rim, goes in. Kruger makes his first foul shot. 2:22 to go here in the second. Trolling up by a score of 28. Makes the second. Reuther didn't put on a bad performance in this game. They actually had some pretty impressive looks on the offensive side of the ball. It just came too little too late. They really struggled in that first half as Shoreland comes down after the turnover. Tries to secure the rebound. It goes off them, so that will be Reuther ball. They really did manage to adjust coming out of the locker room at the end of the first half. It just was too little too late for them. They'd already fallen behind almost 20 points at the end of the first half. 41. That's Nolan Kruger down the other end of the court. Can't get a good shot off, however. That is going to be a travel going back the other way. Carthage College, of course, playing a wonderful host to all of today's games. Tries to shoot into traffic, no luck. Kicks it out. Rattles out. The rebound is secured by Shoreland. Only a couple more possessions for both of these teams. Then we will have a final. I'd like to remind you, stick around. We're going to have the player of the game presented at the end of this one, as we will for all the rest of our six games we have today. From three, beautiful teardrop three. That's Janadi Thomas, the senior, number 42. Air ball on that attempt there. 25 seconds. And I believe we will see the clock wind down on this one. Thank you again for tuning in. Your final will be Shoreland 67 and Reuther 35. Just a moment, we will have our presentation of the player of the game. I'd like to remind you that this broadcast is brought to you by WGDD Sports and is sponsored by Carthage College, which guarantees graduation in 4 years to all students who meet criteria, ranked one of the best values in the Midwest. Doctors of Physical Therapy, get back to what you love doing with the care of DPD. Their specialists provide a treatment plan to getting you moving. Visit doctorsofphysicaltherapy.com. Wisco Huddle, love high school sports? Subscribe to the Wisco
right,
Huddle.
Hold on 1 second. We got the player of the game ball.
Here's a presentation of player of the game.
Big applause for the two teams, Shoreland, Luther. Congratulations, guys. Our Honda player of the game, Honda Coach player of the game, goes to number 21, Antonio Moyo. 7 points, 6 rebounds, 5 assists. Honda official stats, congratulations.
Moyo really had a strong half for Shoreland, kind of set the pace for the rest of the game.
All right, next game.
So a big win for the Shoreland Pacers. We'll move on to highlights. Second half. Reuther came out stronger at the start of the second half. but just really struggled to find any sort of success on offense that would allow them to keep pace with Shoreland. It was better, it just wasn't good enough. And so, in spite of the effort by Reuther at the end of the game to try and pull it back, really, this was Shoreland's from the beginning, the end of the day, final score, Shoreland 67, Reuther 35. Stick around, we've got our second game between the Burlington Demons and the Tremper Trojans coming right up in just a little bit. You're watching WGDD Sports.